हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फजान रूल। बट बिफोर आई स्टार्ट फजान रूल, लेट मी रिकॉल यू वन टॉपिक, आयनिक कैरेक्टर इन कोवेलेंट कंपाउंड। दिस टॉपिक वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन पोलर कोवेलेंट कंपाउंड वीडियो। सो टुडे फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी रिकॉल दिस टॉपिक। ओके, सो टॉपिक इज आयनिक कैरेक्टर इन कोवेलेंट कंपाउंड। सो लेट्स टेक वन कोवेलेंट कंपाउंड लाइक HCl। सो वेन एवर वी टॉक अबाउट द हेटरोएटॉमिक मॉलिक्यूल्स, सो इन हेटरोएटॉमिक मॉलिक्यूल्स व्हाट हैपेंस, देयर विल बी अ इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी डिफरेंस डेफिनेटली। ओके, सो एज इन HCl वी कैन सी दैट क्लोरीन इज मच मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव देन हाइड्रोजन। सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी डिफरेंस व्हाट हैपेंस, द शेयर्ड पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन शिफ्ट्स टुवर्ड्स द मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एटम। And because of this, covalent bond will form with the poles. And because of the presence of these poles, the bond is known as polar covalent bond. Okay? Polar covalent bond means covalent bond with some ionic character as positive and negative charges present with the covalent bond. Okay? And how much ionic character is present in any covalent compound? Or with any covalent bond, this we can calculate ionic character. This we can calculate by using Smith and Henney's equation. This we have already discussed in polar covalent compound video. Okay, so as a result of this topic, we can say that no bond is purely covalent. In all covalent bond, there will be a ionic character in some extent. And in how much extent, this we can calculate by using this equation. Okay, so similarly, now let's talk about the covalent character in ionic compounds. So let's take one ionic compound like LiCl. So we know that what happens in ionic compound. In ionic compound, one atom transfers its electron to the another atom, and after gaining the electron, it will have negative charge and it will have positive charge. And because of this positive and negative charge, they will bind up with each other and will form a ionic compound like LiCl in Li positive and Cl negative case. Okay. So now today we'll talk about the about what happens after the formation of ionic compound. Okay, so here LiCl is formed. Okay, and in LiCl, Li is present like Li positive and Cl is present like Cl negative. Okay, or we can draw these ions like this. Okay, this is a cation and this is a anion. Okay, so we know that when Li converts into Li positive, it has to lose one electron, and after losing one electron, the size of Li will also decrease. Okay, as we know that in Li electrons are 3, protons are also 3, but in Li plus electrons are 2 but protons are 3. So here per electron effective nuclear charge increases, that's why size decreases. Okay, so in this case we can say that positive charge is present in small density. Okay, or we can say that in this Li positive there is a high electron density than Li. Okay, so because of this high density of electron, what it will do, and here also our effective nuclear charge is also greater than this Li. Okay, so what Li plus will do, Li plus will attract the electron cloud of this anion. Okay, and when it pulls the electron cloud of anion, the shape of this anion changes like this. Okay, because it is pulling the electron cloud of this anion. Okay, so this is called distortion of electron cloud of anion. Okay, and this distortion is known as by this term polarization. Okay, so this is called polarization. This distortion of electron cloud of anion by cation is known as polarization. Okay, so whenever polarization increases, what happens, polarization increases means cation will pull the electron cloud of anion more effectively. So when it will pull the electron more effectively, then there will be the decrease in the positive charge of cation, as positive charge is present because of the deficiency of electron, and here it is pulling the electron of anion, so there will be decrease in the positive charge of cation, and also here there will be the decrease in negative charge of anion also. So because of this decrease, covalent character increases. Okay, so as a result of this, we can say that whenever polarization increases, covalent character in ionic compound increases, and when polarization decreases, covalent character in ionic compound also decreases. Okay, and this covalent character or this polarization we can compare by using Faisan's rule. Okay, so today we will discuss the same rule, Faisan rule, which is which we will use to identify the covalent character in ionic compounds. Okay, so let's start the Faisan rule now. Okay,